Helicon. We are in Vancouver with the beautiful and very talented Emma Hewitt from Australia. How's it going?
Good, thanks, Ellie. Hey, guys. How you doing?
I'm good, thanks. We are talking about being healthy on tour, and she has just flown in from Miami. She's here for one night, and then she's flying back to Miami, like, immediately after the show. She's finishing up her club show, you said, around 3:30?
About 3:30, yeah.
Like, literally going straight to the airport to get on her 6 a.m. flight. How long have you been touring for?
About 7 years, really intensely now. So, you know, I was doing a little bit of touring with my rock band before I started doing dance music, but it was nothing compared to the dance music touring I've been doing. So it's kind of constantly country hopping.
So was there a time where, like, was there a moment where you're like, I need to stop eating, like, anything that is available to, like, planning to actually eat healthy?
Yes, there most definitely was. Because the last couple of years, being very naive and young, starting touring, first of all, I was like, oh, there's, you know, you get your rider and you get your buffets or whatever else. So, like, oh, let's have some drinks and let's eat all the carbs the next day because I'm tired. And after a couple of years, I was like sitting on a plane one day going, oh, I've got a stomach that I didn't have before, you know. I realized also being sedentary on planes for so long, you can't just eat everything they bring you because you're bored. But I learned that the hard way. So now, yeah, I kind of really turned everything around with my diet and my exercise while I'm touring. You kind of have to, otherwise you can't survive the grueling schedule, I don't think.
It's really tough. Just the fatigue and just feeling worn out and being sore and tired.
Yes, definitely. And with jet lag and everything too, the thing is you want your quick fix because you've got a show. If you've flown for, say, 14 hours, or for me from Australia, often it's like 27 hours to Europe or something. And you get there and you've got a show, so the obvious thing to do is when you're tired is to eat some carbs to get some energy, have a Red Bull and, you know, have a vodka or whatever else to just get your vibe up. But in the long term, like short term fix, it's good. But long term fix, I realized I started to suffer from that. So it's definitely better to stay healthy the whole way through, and then you don't need to like fall back on the pizzas and the
So do you have a, like a plan? Because I know that I have almost no self-control. I really find it challenging when I'm touring with my band and they're all dudes and they're just like, chicken wings, burgers, whatever. And I'm just like, I don't want the garden salad on the pub menu. Like, do you have a plan? Does everyone on your team work that way? Like, how do you conquer that?
I hear you with that, because a lot of the people that I work with are guys and they can eat whatever they want. And at 6 a.m. after the show, everyone's like, let's get breakfast. Actually, this happened last week. And I was like, oh God, pancakes and things after, you know, after the end of the show. But most of the time now I'm bringing my own protein bars and things like that with me. I always make sure there's tons of water backstage and tons of water wherever I am, so that I'm not tempted to go for, you know, soft drinks or Red Bulls and whatever else. But yeah, it's really hard. Just try and eat as often as I can too, because otherwise I find myself ordering the burger because I'm starving. But especially on planes, it's just taking nuts and seeds and protein bars.
Do you have like a pre-show routine that you do before you get on stage?
Yeah, I do. I usually have some tea with some honey and lemon. I also have a little bit of whiskey because it's good for your voice if I feel like my voice is dehydrated. I know that's not part of the health, but just a tiny bit.
I didn't know that. I always like to have whiskey before the show because I'm nervous.
Yeah, because it calms you a bit.
Now I can say it's for health reasons.
It's good for your voice. Do you notice it warms up your vocal cords? So it actually makes it easier to sing if you're a little bit nervous or anything. So a little bit of that I think is medicinal. It's okay. And just voice exercises for about half an hour. And I try not to talk to people too much before I go on stage, which is super hard if you've got friends there or a meet and greet or something. But I always try and make that after the show. Then I can be like relaxed and chat to everyone.
Zone out and...
Yeah, beforehand I need to just focus on the show and not talking too much so I don't lose my voice.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you so much for talking to me.
Check out Emma online. She's everywhere. She's fantastic. So definitely check her out. She uses our Voice Life 3 Extreme, I believe is what you use,
I do, yes. And that little baby goes everywhere with me. So, that's why I can travel by myself now. Because I've got sound effects that are great.
That's amazing.
Yeah,
check out our YouTube channel. We've got lots of really great footage of Emma showing us how she's using the pedal if you're interested. So, great.
Thanks
so much, Emma.
Thanks, cheers. Thank you.